Jai Hind students, I welcome you all in the very first lecture from the subject Strategic Human Resource Management. This is the subject that deals with the two important aspects, strategy and the human resource management. It is very interesting to know about the contribution of the human resource management in the strategic development in any organization. So this is the subject where we will discuss about the various things, various modules, various concepts which are related with the strategic human resource management. We will discuss about the evolution of SHRM. We will discuss about the various strategic approaches that are associated with the HRM practices inside the organizations. While we talk about the strategic human resource management, this is the concept that has given the basic importance to the people power. If you have any organization and lot of resources are there, but the human resource or the employees of that organization are not so good, in that case, it is very difficult for that organization to gain the competitive advantage or to gain the best of the profits. So that's why strategic human resource management plays a crucial role. It is all about the employees, those who plays the crucial role in the organizations. It is the people power that talks about the success of any organization. There are various organizations which has the name and fame in the market. They are the organizations like L&T, like Reliance Group. Then we can have the example of Patanjali Group. We can have the example of like Wipro, HCL, Amazon. Lot of companies are really doing well. So what do you think? It is only the financial power that is working for these companies? It is only the infrastructure that is working for these companies? No, not at all. It is the people power. It is the employee motivational power. It is the employee commitment that works for all these kind of the companies. So that's why this is the subject that deals into the importance of the human resource management. It talks about the strategic association of the human resource management with the strategic formulation in the organization. In this subject, we will discuss about lot of things. We will discuss about the association of strategic planning with the HR planning. We will discuss about the role of the HRM activities and policies in the business strategies. We will also discuss about the various patterns that are used by the organizations in gaining the maximum advantage from the employees. It is the subject that talks about the integration of the HRM activities with the strategies of the organization. While we talk about the strategic human resource management, it means a strategic look at the HR functions. It talks about the opportunities and threats and the association of these opportunities and threats with the current HR practices. It talks about the company strengths and weaknesses, and it says that the company strengths and weaknesses again comes from the people. Like if the organization has the good human resources, so that becomes the main strengthen point for that particular organization. This subject also talks about the implementation of these strategies while keeping in mind the HR functions and the philosophies and the policies. And then it also talks about the evaluation and the control of activities. While we talk about the SHRM framework, the beginning of this concept starts from the corporate strategy formulation. While any company makes its strategies, it talks about or it considers the external environment and the internal environment. External environment includes all the micro and the macro factors, and internal environment includes all the internal factors that are associated with any company. So while company makes its strategy, it works in the external, always takes into consideration the external factors and the internal factors. Based on the corporate strategy, the HR strategies may be formulated. For example, if a company thinks about the strategy that they want to just target the segment of the population, those who are the middle class and those who cannot afford the expensive products. If they are, for example, according to Porter, if they are just dealing into the cost leadership strategy. So HR strategies are accordingly formulated. So this is the framework for the strategic human resource management. It says that whatever is the corporate strategy, the HR strategies are formulated according to the corporate strategy. And when we talk about the HR strategic formulation, it includes the job analysis strategy, staffing strategy, development strategy, appraisal and reward strategy, employee relations strategy. And at last, there must be a scope for feedback and evaluation also. If we talk about in detail about all the functions of the HR, as I said, that if a company is going to use the cost leadership strategy, so in that case, like all the other activities which are related with the HRM will also be made accordingly. Like they would not be very expensive, like the staffing practices would be there, but the organization will try to reduce the cost of the expenses which are associated with the recruitment. The organizations will also try to provide the in-house training to the employees so that to deduct or reduce the cost to a great extent. Even the appraisal and the reward strategies will also be formulated keeping in consideration the cost. And even the employee relations strategies will be there. Organization will always want to have their old employees with them. And as such, the organizations will work in the favor of the employees always. So this is all about like how the HR strategies are dependent on the corporate strategies. And when we talk about the SHRM framework, as we saw in that diagram, it starts from the strategic formulation and then strategy implementation and then strategy evaluation. Now the question here arises from where the SHRM has come. In India, it was TISCO, that is the Tata Iron and Steel Company, that first started with this concept. Earlier in the year 1947, there was a concept of personal department. Like in the case of the human resource management, it was called as the personal management. There was more of the mechanistic organizations. The organization structure was totally bureaucratic. High centralization was there, high formalization was there, and there was very less flexibility inside the organization. Like there was the rigidity in the rules and the regulations that were followed by the people in the organization. Then in the early 1970s, the term personal management was replaced by the term human resource management. And there were few changes into the HRM approach. More of the organization have the organic pattern then. There was a system of cross hierarchy or cross functional team concepts were there. There was more of the decentralization. Formality was less and there was flexibility in the organizational rules and policies. They were not very rigid. Then with the improvement in the human resource management area, like in 1980s or early 1980s, the concept SHRM emerged and the HRM was as a concept was converted into the SHRM. In that, it talked about the association of the business strategy with the human resource strategies. This was a proactive approach to the HRM. It said that like if the HR department or HR policies may influence the business strategies or may work in the favor of the business strategies, then that organization can really do well. If the organization has cost leadership strategy, so the HR strategies must be accordingly changed and should be according to the business strategy. Like if the organization has the focus strategy, so again it is the HR department, like they should work on that and they should try to associate that business strategy with the HR strategy. So from the year 1980s, SHRM as a concept came into existence and it got a lot of appreciation from the various companies. The people inside that organizations or the employees of that organization were also very happy with the evolution of the SHRM because they gave a lot of importance to the employees. So that's why this is all about the evolution of the SHRM. When we talk about the HRM and SHRM, so there is a difference of one word, that is strategic. But there are a lot of differences in between both of these terms. Let us understand the difference between HRM and SHRM. HRM means the governance of manpower of the organization in a thorough and structured manner, while SHRM is a managerial function which implies framing of HR strategies in such a way to direct employee efforts towards the business strategy or towards the goal of the organization. HRM is reactive in nature, while SHRM is proactive. Staff specialists are responsible for all the HRM functions and the implementation of the policies. But in case of SHRM, it is having a generalistic approach, and it says that it is not only the responsibility of the HR department to see the activities, it is the responsibility of all the line managers to look after the people management. Then in HRM, the approach is fragmented, but SHRM talks about the integration of the business strategy with the HR strategy. It is concerned with the employee relations. It is concerned with internal and external relations. It is short-term planning. It is related with the long-term planning of the organization. It is related with the capital and products. It is related with people and knowledge. It follows change. It initiates change. It is a cost center. Earlier, the employees were taken as the expense or a cost, but it takes the employees as the investment. It takes as like if the employees are good, so that is a great investment by the company, and the company can really do well into the market with the best of the employees. So it talks about the stringent control over the employees, but it talks about the leniency. Like there should not be hard and fast kind of the approach or the rules for the employees. So if you will give them the freedom, then they would be more creative and would just serve your company in a best way. So these all are the various basic differences in between the HRM and SHRM. Now the next question arises here, strategic fit, a conceptual framework. What is called a strategic fit? There is always a dilemma, like whether if I'm going to start with my company or if I have an old company, so first I should make the business strategy and then accordingly I should have the HR strategies, or I should just first check my resources or the HR strategies and then accordingly I should go to adopt any business strategy. What I should do? So most of the renowned personalities in the field of human resource management has suggested that always whenever the organizations used to just make the decisions, so first they should make the business strategies and then accordingly they should just make available the resources like employees and the other HR practices and policies should be made, should be changed, should be moderated according to the business strategies. When we talk about the various approaches under the SHRM and when we talk about the various strategic fits, it was Guest who introduced in 1989 the five important strategic fits that can take place in any organization. The first was called as a fit as a strategic interaction, that means the best fit approach. This approach says that HR strategies should be matched with the business strategies. Like it is the business strategy that should be first prepared by any business owner, and then accordingly the HR practices should be molded according to the business strategies. Then the next was the contingency HR approach. The third was best practice approach. The fourth was gestalt approach. And the fifth was called as the bundles approach. Out of all these five fits, the three main popular fits are named as the best fit approach, the HR bundle approach, and the best practice approach. When we talk about the various fits, as I told you about the five fits, so you can also represent them in the form of diagram. Then let us first talk about the best fit approach. This approach talks about the linkage of the HR strategies with the business strategies. This linkage is also referred as external fit or the vertical integration. It says that first the business strategies are decided and then accordingly the HR strategies should be prepared or should be moderated according to the business strategies. This concept says that the business orientations or strategies of organization gives rise to the need for different types of people as well as diverse approaches towards investment in the human capital. So first, business owner should just always work on the business strategies. There may be the various bases of the classification of the HR strategies. When we talk about any organization and if we are talking about the business strategies of any organization, there may be the cost leadership strategy, there may be differentiation strategy, or there may be focus strategy. So So whatever the company has a strategy, the HR strategies should be molded according to that business strategy. When we talk about the business strategy, best fit approach also talks about the various stages that are there into the business or the product cycle. These stages are called as startup stage, growth stage, maturity stage, decline stage. And this best fit approach also suggests that HR practices are always changed according to the life cycle stage of the product. Whenever the company product has the startup stage, so in HR practices, there is always a flexible patterns of work. Highly motivated employees are recruited, like a best competitive pay is given to the motivated employees, and there is always a less formality and there is no unions. But gradually when the company start growing, in that stage the HR practices also, there is a change into the HR practices. There is more sophisticated recruitment and selection procedures which are followed. Then training and development activities are given the prime importance at the growth stage. There is specific performance management systems, reward systems, and the focus is on the high commitment of the employees. Then after the growth stage, the product goes through the maturity stage. So at this stage, the company again changes is the HR practices, because now the product is mature. In that case, like company used to think a lot and they try to just reduce the control or reduce the labor cost, and they try to increase the productivity, and they also try to control the compensation at that stage. Like, and then once after the maturity stage, the one more stage comes into the life of any product, that is called as the decline stage. It is the stage where the product is not liked by most of the people, by the consumers, and the product is at its declining stage. So at this stage, the company cannot expend a lot of amount on the employees, and accordingly the HR practices and the strategies are changed. So this is somehow that how the stages in the business or the product cycle may impact the HR practices inside the organization. Then again, the business strategies or the HR strategies are dependent on the types and number of products. The company who deals into the single products, and that too there is nothing like a new innovation into them. So in that cases, the HR strategies may be simple, and even the procedures for performance appraisal and the reward management may be like simple and may be like done in a paternalistic manner. There is no need of any new things or new creativity into all that prevalent HR practices. But in case if the organization is dealing into the innovative products and it is really into the need of the employees, those who can just provide the best of the ideas. So in that sort of organization, because the product demands the talented employees or the innovative employees, so in that case, the HR strategies are accordingly changed. Like most of the expenses are done on the as an investment on the like human resources. The organization used to provide a lot of the chances to their employees for their career development, and they always try to make them more committed. They want to retain that employees, those who are really intellectual and provide the new ideas to the company. So the scene is totally changed. It all depends on the kind of the products in which you are dealing in. If that is a product which is like of a simple nature and there is no new innovation into that, so there the outdated technologies or outdated HR policies may work. But in case if the company deals into the best of the new products or the innovative products, so in that case the outdated HR practices may not work. So it all depends on the type and number of products. So this is all about the best fit approach, and this approach also talks about the various HR strategic classifications. Like according to lot of the authors have given their own classification of the HR strategy. And when we talk about the best fit approach, so we will discuss about all these various authors, those who have just contributed in the field of the strategic human resource management and the strategic management. The first name that came into the picture, and most of the people recognized it and today even appreciated it, the name is Michael Porter. Porter suggested that there may be three kind of the strategies inside the company. Then Sculler and Jackson said something. So let us just discuss one by one. Porter suggested that any company has one of the strategy out of three competitive strategies. It may be cost leadership, it may be differentiation, it may be focus. Cost leadership strategy is a kind of strategy in which the firm tries to increase its efficiency even after cutting the cost so that products or services may be priced lower than the industry average. Vishal Mega Mart is the example of such kind of the business strategy. Then there may be the differentiation strategy also. In this strategy, the people try or even the company try to just provide the unique product to the consumers. Consumers are not bothered about the prices. They always want the best of the product and that should be unique. So differentiation strategy has its own pattern. Nike, Sony, BMW cars, all these are the examples of the differentiation strategy. Then the companies may work on the focus strategy also. When the company is focused on a particular segment of population and they only try to just satisfy the wants of that segment of population. So that may be called as the focus strategy. For example, like Lakme. This is a company that deals into the cosmetics and that too like they deal into the cosmetic products and specifically they used to cover the one of the segment of the population that is the female. So this is somehow called as the focus strategy. We can also have the example of Raymond's, like it always gives the preference to the official wear for man and women. So that's why focus strategy focuses on a specific segment of population. So there may be any kind of the strategy and according whatever is the strategy, business strategy, the HR strategies will be formulated accordingly. In case of cost leadership strategy, the HR strategy would again be like that. They would try to just use or like maximum exploit the existing resources which are available with them, even the human resources. In the case of the HR strategy, they have the narrow career paths, limited employment security, and cost cutting may involve incentives or employees to leave the firm. Like cost cutting is the main approach in the case of the cost leadership strategy. While in differentiation strategy, like it talks about the creative job behavior, it talks about the new innovations and ideas, and there is nothing, they are not bothered about the prices and the cost. So in this case, the HR strategy would be the facilitation HR strategy. There would be the extensive training programs that would be provided to the employees. There would be equal and fair pay and lot of the incentives will be given to the employees, are usually given to the employees for their creativity. So it is just a change. It all depends on the company philosophy, how they think, whether they think about the cost leadership or whether they think about the differentiation. Then the companies may have the focus strategy also. Focus strategy is a kind of strategy in which they have the focus on a particular segment of population. So in that case, again it has the accumulation HR strategy. There is a equal and fair pay with many incentives that is provided to the employees. The employees are hired which are belonging to the target market. There is a maximum employee participation. So the whatever is the strategy, the HR strategies would be like moderated accordingly. So this is the first concept that was just given by Porter. And the best fit approach says that whatever is the best strategy for your company, you have to mold the HR strategies of that companies accordingly. Then there was one more author named as Myland Snow. He said that in any kind of a company, you will find whether they will act as like a defender, prospector or analyzer. Defenders are the kind of the business owners, those who find the change threatening. They always favor the strategies which encourage continuity and security because they always try to defend and change is threatening for them. So they do not want to spend a lot of amount on their employees. And because of such reason, the HR strategies are prepared in a totally different manner. There is a bureaucratic approach. They try to plan and regulate the policies and they always try to work with the lean HR, like with the best of the, without less or without no wastage of time and the resources, they want to just work more. So that kind of philosophy is always there inside the organization. They try to work on their existing employees. They spend very less amount on the employees because they always have the target to just reduce the cost. And it is just like a cost leadership strategy, like the business owners are trying to defend them. And as such, the HR strategies are also impacted by this kind of the like philosophy of the top management. Then there may be the prospectors. They are the kind of the business owners, those who always thrive for change. They are not bothered about the risk and the prices of the products. So in that case, because the philosophy of the management is totally different, the HR strategies would again accordingly would be totally different. There would be more place for the creativity and flexibility in the management. Like there would be more emphasis that would be given to the training and development of the employees. There would be the good systematic evaluation of the performances of the employees, and accordingly there should be a best of the reward management practice also. Then so accordingly, whatever is the strategy, because now the prospectors are there into the picture, so HR strategies would accordingly be formulated, and there would be a complete change into them as compared when it was a defender kind of the HR strategy. Then there may be the analyzers. These are the people, those who do not follow the defending kind of the thing, or those who are not the prospectors. Even they are the people, those who just work with their experience, and they try to just amalgamate the advantages of both the defending strategy and the prospecting strategy. So there is always a decision keeping into mind both of the above strategies, or the defenders and the prospectors. These are the kind of the firms which are called as the followers. They first used to analyze, used to check each and every aspect in the market, and then accordingly they work on their strategies. HR strategy in the case of the analyzers again is very different. There is always a low level of monitoring and coordination. There is a buy as well as make key human resource system inside these organizations. So this is a change. So Mile and Snow suggested that wherever you will go for a job, you will find out of these three patterns, you will find one pattern. Either there would be the defender kind of system, there would be a prospector kind of system, or there may be the analyzer kind of the system. Then Golden and Ramanujam said that whenever you will visit any of the organization, you will find a place for the HR. And whatever is a place of the HR, that may be divided into the four categories. In some of the organization, you will find HR as an administrative function, which is responsible to just provide the rotational operational support, which is to just make the various policies. Then there may be one-way linkage, like where the HR function is just all dependent on the strategic planning, and the HR function reacts to and designs the HR programs according to the strategies of the firm or the organization. The third way may be the two-way linkage, in which there is a reciprocal and interdependent relationship between strategic planning and the HR function. There may be integrative linkage also, where the HR function has given a great importance. Then Sculler in 1992 suggested that while when we work on the strategic business needs, it may be connected with the strategic HRM activities, there are total 5 P's that may help in strategic formulation or in the good management of the company. These 5 P's are HR philosophy, HR policies, HR programs, HR practices, and HR processes. So while any organization try to integrate their strategic business needs with these 5 P's, that organizations can really do well and can have a great success in future. So this was just all the like decision of the scholar, and he suggested this in his research. So this is all about the explanation of the various authors, those who have contributed in the field of the strategic management and have tried to associate the HR function with the business strategies. So this is all about the first approach that was named as best fit approach. But there are certain drawbacks of this approach. In this approach, there is nothing which is talked about the employee's interest. So that's why it was criticized. Even this approach talks about the various competitive strategies, and even that strategies they have taken as a typology. But in organization, there is always an uncertainty, and we cannot function with a particular competitive strategy. So in that case, the whole pattern or the homework by the HR function may be a complete wastage. So that's why it was criticized on that ground. And then some of the people says that organization works in a dynamic scenario. But this is the strategy that talks about a strict pattern. This kind of the pattern may not be workable in the dynamic scenario. So all these are the drawbacks of the best fit approach. and then the HR bundles approach and the best practice approach. These approaches we will discuss in our next lecture. I believe this lecture is clear to you and you got to know about the importance of SHRM through this lecture. Thank you.